Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Spitting Venom, aka the Venom Vlog. And today, I'm probably on bed rest while you're watching this, so I will get to comments and and reply to stuff as soon as I can. Thank you for watching the video so far for season 3 of the show. I'm glad we're rolling into it. We'll have more movie news and everything coming up as Venom crosses 800 million and other things. We'll get to those as soon as I can. But right now, as of today, none of that stuff has happened yet, so I'm just covering stuff that I have currently that I can talk about. So we did the comic book review in the last episode. And in this episode, we're actually going to just briefly look at this amazing statue from Diamond. Diamond Select Toys. This is a $45 statue. You can get at GameStop. You can get at your local comic store. You can get on Amazon, I believe. And I was lucky enough, I put in a pre-order for this a while ago, but it didn't show up. I didn't get the notification that it came in or that I got charged for it. So I guess it never went through. So the other day I was going to the comic store to pick up Venom number 8, and I was like, all right, this was the week I was supposed to be on bed rest. It didn't happen. So I have a little bit of extra money from my check that I was saving, because I was like, oh, after my bed rest, I might want to get myself something to like cheer myself up. And I was like, all right, well, it looks like we're buying it before my surgery now, since my surgery got moved. So I went ahead and bought this, and I was like, I don't really have the money, but I, at the same time, I kind of did, because I had to fix my car last week, and I had money left over from that. And basically my last check I got was like a free check. It was like I was able to use some of it to pay for a few bills and a couple things, but I had like a ton of money left over, which I wasn't expecting, because normally I'm broke during the middle of the month. So it was nice to see that I actually had money, and I was like, well, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and get this for the back. I wanted to put it on that shelf back there, so I rearranged some stuff. So where that black cat image is by Tyler Kirkham, that artwork, you're gonna see this Venom statue put up on that shelf. But yeah, so it's only $45. So I went into Legacy Comics, picked up Venom number 8, and I saw this. They had one of them, and I was like, all right, I gotta buy it. That's a sign right there to not let it slip from my grasp. And the box art is always great. I love these things. You saw that I did the, if you watch my Joker show, the Batman Who Laughs. I bought one of those recently, and that was supposed to be my get well surgery gift to myself. But then when this came out, I was like, all right, I'm splurging here, but I'm gonna totally do it. So now I have this. Let's pop it open and let's check it out and see all the detail. Check this guy out. This thing is awesome. I love the detail on this guy, and what I'll try to do is I'll try to put up some cutaways of, like better images and, kind of pan around so you can kind of see him from every angle. I'll show him here too, but I'll also try to have like, some close-ups and stuff, pop up on screen while you're looking at it. But yeah, this guy is so great. I love these statues. They're made of PVC and the material, and it's like, so it keeps it the price point down. I used to love collecting statues when I lived in Florida. I bought like a bunch of the black and white Batman statues, and then as they were first coming out, and then moved out here to LA, and then I put them on a shelf, and my first earthquake in LA knocked the shelf off the wall. I guess I didn't mount it as well as I could have, and then knocked the shelf off the wall, and there was like 5 Batman black and white statues that hit the ground and shattered. And so ever since then, I've been really shy about buying statues. But then ever since these came out, I've been kind of interested. There's actually one more I'd like to get at some point, which is the Hardak Batman statue from the animated series where he's like half robot. I might get that at some point down the road. But I mean, I'm kind of broke for a while. I got to save money for medicine and other things I'm going to need post-surgery and food and stuff. So this was nice to get as like a last minute gift. Again, like, I'm not that I deserve anything else or like really should treat myself at all. I always feel guilty when I buy myself something like that's over like $40 when it's like one thing, because I just, I kind of live check to check, so it's kind of hard sometimes. But it was nice to have a little bit of extra money to be able to do this with. And so yeah, I was able to pick him up, and he looks fantastic. I love seeing the, the suit peeling off of him. The symbol looks really great. It's like, it looks very like flesh patterns underneath there. The detail is really good where the suit is like starting to come over him. The teeth, the mouth, everything, like, it just looks fantastic. And I love how the head is kind of like, I hope they do in the second one, they get better with some of the CGI in the movie and do stuff like this. Because in the first movie, it was like, it was coming around, it came over his head and the mouth shut. That was really cool. But I'd love to see things like, coming around like this and like a Venus flytrap opening up like that. Just, seeing it do weird alien things would be really cool. And to approach Eddie Brock differently and to make it more visually interesting so that you're not repeating the same visuals from the first movie. So I'd like to see something like this, in the second one where it's kind of like clamping over his head in sections. Not so much like the Spider-Man 3 movie where it's like this wet, slow process, but just like this, like I said, like a Venus flytrap opening up, just, or I guess it opens that way, but do it sideways and have it like, and you could see the things peeling off and stuff. That would just look really cool. But the statue is great. I love it. If you have $45 out there and you want to pick it up, like I said, you can get it at GameStop. You can get it at online at Amazon, or you can have your local comic book store order it for you. Just tell them it's the Diamond Select Venom PVC statue, and they can look it up for you guys. So I want to hear your thoughts, now that you've seen some close-up images of it. Let me hear your thoughts down below, and from now on, you'll probably see it on that shelf in future videos. So thank you again. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and we'll continue our conversation down there. And if you have a favorite Venom statue or a favorite Venom toy, let me know what it is. If you like this one, I'd love to hear your thoughts on that. But also, if you have another one that's a favorite of yours or that you love a lot, or like one of those big expensive ones that I won't be able to afford, like the Gentle Giant one, or like that big bust that's coming out, that resin bust that's like $350 or something, of just like his chest and his head. All of those are great. So if you have a favorite of those, again, let me know in the comments below, and we'll continue our, you know, our conversation of what we love most about Venom down there. Thanks so much for watching my show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you in the future. Peace.